Century may be a big number in cricket, but on a human life, century is quite long. But half a century is quite enough to say that we have accomplished a good lifespan in this world. Likewise, car is also having a good lifetime if it is completing around 10 to 12 years. But we have something which is completing 50 years, which is the 50th edition Jaguar XJ, the flagship model from the Jaguar. And this car, even the present generation, has completed 10th year of production. So welcome to this show of Flywheel, and let's explore the XJ50 as part of their 50th celebration of XJ. It was in 1968 Jaguar first introduced their flagship, but it was named as Series 1 then. They come out with Series 1, 2 and 3, then later they named the name XJ. Now we have the X351, which is the latest generation XJ, which was introduced in 2009. And it's still Luke Young, and he's competing with some of the biggest players in the market, like the Mercedes S-Class 7 Series, Audi A8 and the like Lexus LS. Why is it still capable of competing with this is because of the design. Before going to design, I'll take a small tour through the XJ's 50th year. As I said earlier, XJ is one of the most attractive looking cars in the industry right now. No matter whether it's a sports car, maybe it's a sedan or a premium car, XJ has its own stamp which still been written even after 10 years. All credits go to the design team headed by Ian Callum. They introduced a very unique design after a very conventional design of previous generation XJ. And the uniqueness was on this proportion. It's a great proportion, it's a low strung design, but it is actually 1.46 meter tall. It's a low sill out and low greenhouse, which look more sportier and proper coupe like roofline and long hood, short rear. All this matter for the best proportion of a sports sedan. It has got its own identity on the face here and rear, which has like the Jaguar element, like the Jaguar LED light, Jaguar grille on the front. There's a chrome treatment which is on the bumper. On the rear, there's a tail light, which is a vertical tail light, which has got a cat car on the tail light, which resembles the Jaguar. A clean boot lid and a decent boot space all matters for this design. Whatever it is, the car still look young, and it's competing with one of the biggest players, which are all the flagship of all the competitors. When you come to the interior of the XJ, it is inspired actually from yacht. So that has been revealed everywhere in this interior, starting off with the wooden trim, which starts on the top of the dashboard, is continued onto the rear pad. Look attractive. Jet inspired air vents are the center. There is a Jaguar XJ clock, which is an analog clock, which give a classic touch. Below that, there is a touchscreen which has been improved massively from the facelift, so the touch function and the quality is very good. There are immense number of switches which is good to control or substitute the touch function, and there's a piano black center console which look attractive. As you know, rotary knob is for the gear selection. The steering wheel is mostly inspired from the Jaguar Sport pedigree, so you can see that submerged hub and a raised wheel portion which feel really sporty. There's a LCD monitor for the meter console as well. The quality of interior is sublime. It's like a British craftsmanship. Everything is in good shape, except couple of mismatch on the fit and finish, like the alignment on the dash and the door pad. A bit of realignment should be done. Apart from that, a couple of ergonomic drawbacks which I've seen. One is this touch function for this glove box, which one way it look odd because of one button is standing out on this interior. Secondly, it's very sensitive. Just if you accidentally touch the button, it get open. Another thing is, which I wanted to tell during the drive, but which mentioning here is the A pillar. It's bold and strong, but it is actually killing the view. And I felt the XJ should have had some bottle holder in the front, which is absent. Only cup holders are here. So otherwise, it's a well-crafted interior. Seats are very supportive. It's a good backrest and support. Thigh support is also good. You can even control the seats on the touch function, where you can control the airflow, like cool or hot. Maybe also you can control the massage function. So that way, the interior is crafted really well. And I have to mention about the Meridian sound system, which is surround sound. It's also very effective, very crystal clear sound. The panoramic sunroof is there. On the front and the rear, there are separate curtains, and you can even open it if you want to get good breeze inside. But I'm not doing it right now because it's tremendously hot over. Rear seat experience of what I'm thinking is to experience while driving. This is the interior of XJ. When you talk about the XJ, it's a flagship model of Jaguar, and as you know, flagship cars are always meant to be ridden than driven. So a lot of concentration are gone on to the rear end, maybe the rear seat. So Jaguar, when they developed this new XJ, they had two wheelbase form. One was a short wheelbase, another one was a long wheelbase, which we are having here. It's the XJ50, which is the long wheelbase one. So all the space has gone to the rear end. So you can see a lot of roominess is there, even when the seats are set in a way that normally built at like around 5'8", 5'9", can sit in the front. Maybe I'll show you with the press of a button here, I can pull the seat behind and forward. So maybe this will be a setting for a guy who is 6'2". Even then, there is enough knee room for me. Apart from that, there's a misconcept of the rear headroom of the XJ because of the sloping roofline. It's a coupe-like roofline, but I can say you this much headroom is there. I'm 5'8", but a person, maybe a 6'2 guy, can even sit without brushing his hair on the top. So when you are an owner of this XJ, you have the privilege to have more space. So you can adjust it from here. So once you adjust this, the front seat can go forward maximum, and even you can put the rest down, but it won't go completely down because this car is not designed or meant for that. If you done so, the driver's view will be cut and there'll be safety issues. So once you've done that, it is having enough space like in any of the normal long wheelbase S-Class or maybe 7 series or maybe 8. So the room for your leg is quite enough. Maybe you may miss some footrest or maybe cuff support for this rear end, but you have enough space. Apart from that, you can select a massage function with touch of a button. There are three massage options here, and you can even adjust your lumbar support. And there are infotainment system for that. I think I have to pull this. Apart from that, if you want to lean ahead more, you can do it with the press of a button. There's a slight slant towards the rear, and even you can adjust the seat in a way that it lean ahead, little up. Cushiony support for you, and there's a footrest also, and it's a good space. That's a good position to get a good nap after a tiring day. And for me, the day is not over, so I'm not getting a nap because it will take away my concentration on my show. So there's a control unit, it's a remote over here. So to control that, there's an infotainment system, and you can use that system with this remote control. For that, I'm putting the seat back, and with the press of a button, there is a screen like a tab. We popped up. You can use your infotainment. You can enjoy your music or video with this. If you don't want your driver to get disturbed about that, there's a wireless earphone available, which can also be controlled. But I'm not in a mood to enjoy music or entertainment now because my eye is still on that training wheel. Before I go and shift on there, I will tell you, a ride is sublime. It can compare it with the ride of most of its competitors. May not be the best, but it's not that bad, not behind most of the new cars which are in the market. Considering that this 10-year-old car, it still have a very good sublime ride.
suspension is tuned in a way that you don't get much of the harshness or bump into the car, and a 19-inch wheel and the profile of the tire also play a good role to give you a good ride. I had to mention one more thing. There's a table over here which can be unfolded. Maybe you can have some food or maybe you can use the laptop, but I don't have both. So what I have to do is I can enjoy my own drum over here. My time to get onto the wheels. When you talk about the driving experience of the XJ, it calls me back to one of my best memories in my driving experience, which was in neighboring Nordschleife, wherein I was there for a Jaguar driver training program. I was driving a couple of Jaguars. That was the time when F-Type was not launched, so XKRS was the supreme sport machine then. And I was also driving XJS variant, which is supercharged 500 plus HP car. One thing really liked about the car was the dynamics, because it's been developed to the Nordschleife, so that dynamics really played a big role in this car. So small wheel spin and this quickness really matter for this car. This, I'm taking a bend in 125, I can't say the speed, but no. So this steering plays a great role. It's giving a lot of confidence on this car. Suspension also has been tuned that way. So it's been developed around Nürburgring. Nordschleife means it's a great driving machine. It's one of the best, or maybe the best, in this segment. I know there are BMW 7 Series, S-Class and 8s, everything around. Except the new 8, I've driven everything. So normally it's been said that BMW has the greatest driving machines, but in this segment, I have to say this is the best driving machine. It's more dynamic and still more athletic and young, like a new Olympian, or maybe whether, I don't know whether I can say Usain Bolt again, but again, he's one of the biggest athletes. So it's one of the biggest athletes in the premium luxury segment for driving. So coming back to the other aspect of the car, it's an amazing machine. Still look very young. Still feel very young. That means a lot, because once you are in a market for a car which is a timeless classic, this is one car which you can acquire now. Because as I said earlier on one of my reviews of Civic, last generation Civic which was in India was still a timeless car. Like this is still a timeless car. You can see how much it grab attention on traffic that way. So this car has its own charm which is unparalleled right now. So car lovers who are in the league to get some timeless machine, this is an amazing car. Apart from that, it's having all the safety norms which are there, like the lane keeping assist, everything, which are actually active and passive safety features. And the car is built also very light. It's fully aluminium, and that aluminium construction has given all the advantage for this powertrain to give out more power output. It's having a 3-liter diesel engine, and the power output is 306 HP and around 659 below 700 Nm of torque. So that, with this 8-speed set of gearbox, gives out a great driving experience for this car. So it's an amazing machine. I was having a great time with this XJ50. Hope you guys had a great time. Please do like it and share it. And if you're yet to subscribe to our channel, please subscribe right now and click that bell button to get notified at the earliest.